I actually include this as part of the meditation because it's important to establish a kind attitude towards your body, first of all. So just checking that your body is actually ready to meditate rather than demanding that it do your beck and call. So, checking if the posture you chose before is the one you want now. There's plenty of chairs. Noticing maybe the temperature in the room. Sensing into your body. Feeling the connection with the floor, whether you're seated on the floor or you have your feet firmly planted on a cushion or on the ground. Just asking your feet, your legs, your buttocks, if they'd like to wiggle or move a little bit. And noticing the feedback from your feet, or your buttocks, your back. They enjoy to be seen, to be listened to, tended to with kindness. And perhaps breathing in a few fairly slow, deep breaths. Feeling the uplift from the in-breath. And releasing tension, stress, anything that's holding tightly with the out. Inviting your body to relax. Noticing the silence in the room. And allowing any noise, any so-called music to stay on the edges of your mind. Way away in the big city. But here you're just quiet inside. And perhaps just beginning, if you wish, by just allowing your attention to flow from the top of your head, across your scalp, forehead, face, part by part towards the very tips of the toes. Perhaps once again connecting to this idea of someone with kindly and non-judgmental eyes. Imagining your mindfulness as it flows down through each and every part of the body. Being like these non-judgmental eyes that sees and hears whatever's going on for you. these eyes are warm and filled with compassion. That simultaneously relaxes any tension, any pain, imbuing your whole body with kind awareness. Just receiving whatever manifests for you. And at this stage in the meditation, it's still fine to make any adjustments you need to make as you become more aware of your body and what your body needs to feel at ease. Of course, you may change your posture at any time with kindness and compassion, staying mindful with every movement you make. Relating to your body with kindness and respect. For all the amazing things it enables you to do. For being your vehicle for expressing kindness to others and into the world. Noticing with gratitude all the ways your body is healthy, functions well. And smiling into your body with that sense of gratitude and respect. Thank you, body, for allowing me to express kindness, generosity, and so many other good deeds to myself and to those around me, maybe countless beings in this world. Noticing how your body responds to this kindness and gratitude. Perhaps some tingling, a deepening of relaxation. Maybe a warmth in the chest. Or a tingling on the top of the head. Whatever you notice in the body that starts to feel more at ease. Now, if you wish, bringing your awareness to your mental or emotional world, the world of the mind, and noticing what you feel there. Maybe feelings of calm or peace. Maybe sleepiness, sadness. Anxiety. Maybe even guilt or shame. Whatever it is, without judgment, regarding your emotional world with kindly eyes, the eyes maybe of a Buddha, someone who doesn't judge. But allows things space to be. Noticing your intention to be kind to whatever arises in the mind right now. Noticing the beauty of that intention. and forgiving any feelings, thoughts, or emotions that are maybe more disagreeable to you. Allowing them to be there as well, part of life, the effect of so many causes beyond your control. Forgiving your mind, forgiving your life. Embracing things just as they are. And perhaps, if you wish, just bringing to mind something that you've done, a kind word that you've said, a gesture, a smile. Something you've said or done, even a kind thought that you've had. In the last, say, 24 hours. Perhaps saying goodbye to a child, making sure they're well, ready for their day, expressing your love. Baking some flapjacks with your best recipe yet to share instead of just eat alone. Maybe the fact that you've offered yourself this gift of silent practice with spiritual friends. Or that you've awakened the intention within you to embrace and forgive yourself or another, to soften your heart towards life. See if you can connect to the beauty of these pure intentions, these beautiful deeds of body, speech, or mind. And notice how that feels inside. Allowing the mind to quieten, to be safe and relaxed. The knowledge, the trust that you're on the right track, making good use of this human life. So please keep connecting to any thoughts or emotions that cause uplift in your mind. Noticing that beauty within, that potential for good. And either just allowing the mind to quieten, perhaps receiving the breath. If that's what the mind inclines towards, or perhaps using some phrases of loving kindness. Speaking to yourself with kind or compassionate words. Just allowing the meditation to unfold in the best way at this time for you. So we can sit together quietly. And I'll speak again at the end of the meditation. So just trusting the journey, enjoying the ride. And if you find it's hard to develop thoughts of kindness or remember acts of kindness that you might have done, just regarding that with kindness as well, allowing that to be. And as we come closer towards the end of the meditation, just once again connecting with any feelings of self-respect, kindness or compassion towards yourself. Or maybe a sense of forgiving yourself for whatever you think is deficient in you. Forgiving your sleepy mind. Forgiving your meditation for not being quite how you want it to be. But once again, noticing an overall sense of your goodness. Maybe a particular kind act that you've done recently. And imagining offering it into this room to be shared with everybody here, making up so many different acts of kindness, like garlands or flowers on a garland. And offering this garland that we've created together into the world, along with the garlands created by so many other beings, by communities, by imperfect but kind-hearted people everywhere. And joining together with the kind, incredible acts of our heroes or heroines, those who inspire, people we think have done great good in the world. People who've been able to express remorse. To apologize when no one else could. People who've freed their hearts from resentment. And who offer examples of true love in this world. We can contribute our little acts of kindness to the greater good in the world, knowing that everything we do and say counts. So may we dedicate whatever goodness is there in our hearts to all sentient beings. May all beings be happy and well. May all beings be forgiven and forgive themselves. May all beings be free from anger and regret. May we rejoice in the goodness in our hearts. So dedicating the goodness of this practice with all beings and anyone else who comes to mind. Wishing all beings freedom from fear, happiness and health, and deep peace of mind.